is the harsh reality of the circle of life. Flowers aren't meant to last. However, thanks to chemistry, you can help keep them alive just a little bit longer. To keep cut flowers fresh, you've got to fight the flower's normal aging or dying processes. Plants have a straw-like system called xylem to transport water using surface tension. When the stems are cut, air rushes into the xylem, blocking the water system, but more on that later. When you're ready to put your beautiful bouquet in a vase, follow these steps. Clean your vase. It sounds simple, but a little soap and water can go a long way to preventing bacteria and fungi from invading your bouquet. If you're motivated enough, you can even clean the vase and refill the water every day for maximum disinfection. Flowers need water, duh. But it's a little bit more complicated than that. It's best to use warm water that's been slightly degassed, meaning entrapped air has been allowed to escape. The simplest way of doing this is to fill a vase up with warm water and let it sit for a few minutes. The quality of the water also affects the life of the flowers. Plants prefer slightly acidic water that doesn't have too many dissolved solids or fluoride. Next, add that little packet of flower food from the florist. What's inside that thing anyway? First, it has bleach or some other kind of microbe killer. The bleach helps the disinfecting process by killing any microorganisms that are trying to eat away at your flowers and makes it harder for them to thrive. Second, it has citric acid. This lemony goodness reduces the water's pH, which in turn helps the water travel up the xylem faster and reduce wilting. And third, it has sugar. When carbohydrates are low, flowers wilt and petals become paler. To prevent this, sucrose or glucose can be added from the packet to help the flowers regain strength and beauty. But be careful, microorganisms and bacteria love sugar. So that's why you shouldn't just dump table sugar into your vase. You need all the ingredients in that little packet. Run the stems under water and cut off a bit from the bottom of the stem at a 45 degree angle. This ensures a wide opening to the xylem and keeps air bubbles to a minimum. Also, try not to cut the leaves. The leaves are how the plants get energy. Photosynthesis, remember? Once you've made your snips, put those bad boys in a vase. Fruit produces ethylene, which tells a plant to ripen. Faster ripening equals faster dying, which equals dead flowers. Finally, try to keep your cut flowers cool. If you're going to leave the house for a day or two, stick them in the fridge. This reduces microbial growth and decreases the plant's metabolic rate, slowing down the aging process. Kind of like that futuristic cryogenic stuff we're trying on people, but not quite as sci-fi or expensive. So there, you've done it. Congrats. Smell those flowers while you can. Tell us your favorite plant in the comments, and of course, let us know about any future episodes you want to see. Special thanks to chemist and ACS expert Frankie Wood Black for helping with this week's episode. Check out her columns linked in the summary. Smell you later.